In the heart of nature's vast expanse, an age-old dance unfolds. A pursuit as ancient as time itself. Here, in the wild, untamed corners of the world, man and hound come together, testing their instincts and courage against the might and cunning of the bear. This is not merely a hunt, it's a symphony of survival, a testament to the deep-rooted connections between humanity, animal, and the land they share. Throughout the sprawling landscapes of Nevada, bears roam freely across 9 of its 17 counties, all of them in the picturesque western part of the state. The hunting of bears in Nevada began in 2011. I have been putting in for the tag since the hunt's inception and finally pulled it in the 12th year. The odds of drawing this tag are lower than the odds of some bighorn sheep tags, so I was incredibly excited to be selected. Each year, an average of 14 bears are taken in Nevada. When hunting any large game, the goal is always to harvest a mature animal that has had a chance to pass on its genes. Hunting with hounds gives the hunter the ability to properly assess the maturity of the bear, assuring an ethical harvest. Bear meat can be some of the best game meat there is, and a mature bear harvest ensures a full freezer. On the first day, we found ourselves deep in the pinyon juniper forest. Being new to bear hunting and hunting with hounds, we weren't sure what to expect. We learned quickly that the dogs would set the pace and that we were expected to keep up. After a decent walk into a steep canyon, there started to be more and more distance between us and the dogs.
Looks like they're starting to move pretty decent speed. I can't say for sure because they're a mile ahead of us, but they're going up that left fork they did the other day.
At the advice of our guides at Secret Pass Outfitters, we decided to wait and see what the dogs would do. We waited anxiously, listening for the pack to start barking, which would indicate that they had caught a fresh scent. After a while, the dogs came back to us. With no indication of there being bears in the immediate area, we decided to move spots. At our second location, we found ourselves in an even steeper canyon. This time, however, the dogs started barking and trailing almost immediately. This was our first exposure to hearing hounds on fresh scent, and our adrenaline spiked.
We just heard the dogs barking away at the top, which is much more intense than I even expected.
We raced up one side of the canyon to get a better look. The dogs had baited a bear at the deepest part of the canyon, but shortly after, it was able to give them the slip. Day one ended with a newfound love of hunting with hounds and palpable anticipation for what day two might bring. On the second day, we found ourselves in the pinyon juniper forest once again, this time along a large creek. It wasn't long after sunrise that the dogs caught a scent and took off across the creek and up the other side. We knew the creek was fairly deep, so we had come prepared with waders and extra boots to make sure we could stay dry. The terrain in this area mirrored that of our previous locations in that it was incredibly rugged and steep.
Side of the river. The bear's about a little over 800 yards above the river, so we're definitely closing some distance, but still have a ways to go. Well, they're about 600 yards in front of us, so this hike is brutal. It's an incredible hike, but it's brutal. It was a tough hunt.
Upon reaching the dogs, we saw that they had a bear treed in a large pinion. After a close look at the bear, we saw that it was a small sow and decided to pass on it. We pulled the dogs back and hiked back down to the truck and decided to try another location for the afternoon. Our new spot was a stark departure from the spots we had been to up to this point. This area was much less steep, and there were little to no trees. To novice bear hunters like ourselves, this seemed like a pretty unlikely place to find a bear, but we trusted our guides and were glad we did. This particular area had special regulations that required archery equipment only in the form of a bow or crossbow. Because of the way the creek snaked through this area, we knew we would have to cross multiple times, so we ditched our waders and traded comfort for speed. The dogs picked up a scent after only 20 minutes or so. Despite the terrain being mostly flat, it was very challenging to follow the dogs. The brush was incredibly thick, and even the more open spots were deep sand. With no trees here, the dogs had baited a bear in the thick willows. If we wanted any chance of getting this bear, we would have to go into the willows after. As we moved in to get a shot, the bear escaped out of the brush before we were able to get a visual, and the chase was on again. We saw the bear out in the open a few times, well within rifle range, but with only a crossbow available to us, we could do nothing but watch as it slipped away again. Day two ended with us exhausted from the pursuit, but steadfast in our resolve to harvest a bear. On day three, we headed to a new mountain range and used the side-by-side to cover more ground. We had a couple dogs on the platform on the front, and we were hoping that they could pick up some scent. We covered a ton of ground and got the side-by-side into some pretty tight spaces. We ended up seeing a fair amount of bear sign, but the weather was too hot for the dogs to be able to work effectively. On day four, we moved to a completely different area into what I might call classic bear territory. The dogs were on a bear just minutes after hitting the ground. This area had many large mature pine trees, so we were hopeful that the dogs would be able to tree the bear in one of them.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't really know what to expect when I drew the bear tag. I knew it was going to be hard, and I knew we were going to have to work for it. We definitely worked for it this week, and it culminated today on day 4 with a really nice bear. I'm really happy with how everything turned out. One of the best hunts I've ever been on in terms of just excitement and learning a lot of new stuff. Can't say enough about Secret Pass Outfitters. They really gave us a world-class experience and would recommend them anytime. This was absolutely, the peak of what I thought this hunt could be.
So I'm Mike Stremler with Secret Pass Outfitters, co-owner with Dylan Hamm. We had the privilege of hunting with the Talati brothers and their dad. We treed a small bear two days ago and let that one go. That's kind of the beauty of hunting with hounds, is you can judge them when you get up close to them. This particular bear has ear tags in it from being captured in 2019. So we called the wildlife biologist, and it's an 8-year-old sow. It's very mature. We made sure there was no cubs, no cub tracks. So it was a bear that was good to harvest. We enjoyed our hunt, and I'd just like to congratulate you on a good shot and a job well done.